Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video. Today we're going to learn how to light this sofa using a very simple technique. The three-point lighting. This is a very simple setup and I'm gonna get you through all this technique in this tutorial. Okay, so let's get started. This technique consists in three lights: the main light, the fill light, and the backlight. Our camera will be placed in the middle of this shot. Each of these lights has different intensity, different values that will affect the product. Okay, so the main light, this one here, I will put an M for main light, okay? So the main light will be the brightest one. Okay, so the intensity will be very strong. So this one will be our fill light. This will be kind of a medium intensity, and this will help and support the main light. Okay, so let's put something like 2++. Okay, this one has 3++, and the backlight will be kind of a low intensity. Okay, so let's put 1+. Okay, so let's get the ball rolling and see how it works. So the first thing I'm gonna do is create a light. So Shift A, and let's create an area light. Let me divide my viewport so we can see the material, I always forget the name for that, shader editor actually. Okay, so here on the light properties, let's use nodes. So Octane actually automatically create a node for this light. So let's take a look on this light on render. Let's place this light over here. Yeah. Here I have a camera that will be placed in the middle of this shot. So let's get into this camera. Okay, so let's change the texture emission here to black body emission. And plug it on the emission node. I really like this one. This one allows you to change temperature, has a few things different than the texture emission, and for me, it's the best one. So let's put something around 5,000. Something like that. No, let's change it to 6,000. A little cooler. Yeah, much better. Okay, so let's place this light on the right position. So let's say that this one will be our key light. Okay, so let's rotate it. Let's rotate it to something like this. I think it's too high, a little too high. Let's decrease. Let's see like how high it is. So 2 meters is too high. Let's put something around 1 meter and 30, something like this. Okay, so it's important that this light is pointed directly to the sofa, to the object, to the main object, okay? Okay, so let's get into the camera and see the result of this light here. Okay, so the intensity is not too strong, so we have to increase the intensity. So let's put something like 200. That's too much. Let's, it's not 200, Actually, I put 2000. That's why 200. Yeah, I have to keep increasing it. Be 400. Yeah, 500. Not too bad. 600. 800. Yeah, looks like we almost got it. It's important when you are setting up your light that you don't overexposure your object. So this is very, very important. Okay, so you have to keep the highlights, you have to keep the details. So that's what I was trying to preserve. Okay, so for example, if you put 5000 here, like your object will be overexposure. So everything's white and you don't have details anymore. Okay, so let's put it back to 800. Okay, so let's put the fill lights. So let's duplicate this light here. So Shift D. Let's rotate it to something like this. And as I told you, this light will be a little, it will have a little less power than the main light. Okay, so if the main light has 800, this fill light will have around 500. Okay, so let's take a look on the camera. Oh, something happened to my camera. Yeah, actually I changed the view. Okay. Okay, so let's turn off the camera, turn off the light, the fill light, just to see the result. So zero, and then five. Let me turn off here and here. So maybe we can use a little lower than 500. So let's put something around 400. Yeah. And now let's put the last light. That is the backlight. So let's do the same thing. Let's duplicate this one. Rotate it. And to see the result of the backlight, let's hide these two lights here and let's get into the camera. Remember, the backlight has a little bit less power than the medium light, so let's put something around 200. Okay. Oops, I think I changed the medium light, the fill light. So this one should it. Okay. So now I'm gonna change here to the viewport so I can see the effect. The idea here is kind to create a silhouette to the object. Okay, so let's try place this camera, this light a little higher. So we can have this very nice silhouette over here. So let's try to rotate it a little bit more. Maybe we can increase size. Try to bring this silhouette here. Is a very nice silhouette. This adjustment is more kind of an artistic adjustment, so you can play around with it and see the best way to adjust it. So something like this, a little less power, maybe a little closer. Yeah, something like this. Okay, so let's unhide the other lights and see what happens. Here we go. Beautiful result. So this is, again, a very simple technique to light an object. It's an old technique, very, very, very old technique, but most of the designers don't use it. So start to use it. This will guide you through new things. So I think what's missing here, it's probably a floor and a background. So let's add a plane here. And let's put something black, maybe. Something like this. You can always try to do different things here. So maybe, I don't know, extrude this part here, something like this. Bring it close to the lights. Let's take a look. Yeah. Maybe it's too, let's change the color here. Oops. Decrease color, decrease this value here. Specular, maybe it's too much, something like this. So yeah, you can always play around, see different colors as well. It's up to you. So you can play around, that's very cool. Very nice result. I hope, guys, that this video helped you somehow. Again, start to use these 3-point lights. I use it, for example, even in my interior lights, interior scenes. So I try to see the right windows on my interior scene to try to place my object inside the scene based on these three windows. Or maybe I don't have two windows, but I have to create a new light to simulate this 3-point lighting. So this is something to keep in mind. This is how I try to set up my light as well in my scenes. Okay, so I hope this helped you. And thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.